JRA 501. This is a article. I haven't seen a whole lot on this, actually. AT&T offers $250,000 reward for fiber vandalism. This is up in Northern California. About 10,000 gallons of oil leaked Tuesday morning from a transformer at a San Jose PG&E substation, which authorities said was vandalized by gunfire. At the same time, and not too far away, Gilroy and Morgan Hill police departments reported that 911 calls from landlines were not working early Tuesday morning because of cut lines. So that was sabotaged. And while I'm speaking of 911, my prayers go out to everybody that was affected by the Boston bombing. Phone service was restored in the South Bay Wednesday after being disrupted Tuesday when the vandals cut underground fiber optic cables south of San Jose. So then they had the transformer vandalized. And they also had a breach in their security fence. Not too secure. So, this kind of puts it in perspective for me at the moment. You can never be too safe. And the reason why I say that is that there were people, trying to call. They didn't have cell phones. They didn't have internet service. They didn't have access to 911. And so what happens if there is a real emergency? There's nobody to help you. And that's kind of terrifying. So, that leads me into my next spiel. And that is being trying to be safe here. I have an older emergency radio. It's got a red flashing light on it, and you can dial it in, and it's got a battery, big old huge battery in it, and thank God I've never had to use it, but I do want to get something that's more updated, and they do have like these walkie-talkies that are rechargeable. They have the NOAA Weather Plus alerts, vibrates, PTT power boost, flashlight, emergency alert button, mini USB port. So, yeah, that was just something I thought. I've been thinking about getting some of these anyway, especially if it can go 35 miles. I have a friend that I've been talking with that I'm trying to figure out with her, what we would do. Where would we meet? If you could meet, you might have to walk. So yeah, so we're talking. I'm trying to hook up with somebody. And then they do have the standard emergency radios. These are kind of nice because some of them are small, some of them are hand crank. So it's just another option. A lot of options, which is kind of nice. So I'm going to have to look at some reviews for that. And then my other thing is having a decent flashlight. I've got a flashlight in the car, just one of those little small ones. And I've got one in my purse. And I do give those to all of my patients so that they can put that on their nightstand. And if there's no electricity, then they can just grab that and, safely if they have to get up or whatever. Anyway, Yeah, and I do have a friend who has this big giant, it's bigger than this, but she's got this big giant spotlight thing, and it is, I would love to have one. I'm sure it was pretty expensive. But I think this one is $40. You know, just something so you've got some light. You know, how many times have I bought flashlights and I get them home and they're not that great? So if anybody has any tips on either one of those, a little something else to add to my bug out bag, I'd thoroughly appreciate it. Stay alert, people. Stay safe. And just, you know, be prepared to hunker down where you are. Alrighty, as always, God bless.